shall be blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm happy about the religion. Thank you.
that the light has come. That's why I've come here today to release the word of the Lord upon your life. That the light of God is about to visit you. It's about to touch your family, touch your business, touch all that concerns you. Because something is about to happen in your life so powerfully. The reason of the light of the Lord upon your life will expose the works of darkness. And so the scripture says that the light shines in darkness, and darkness comprehends it not. And I stand on the word of God to speak over your life. That as the word of the Lord is going to invade your heart today, whatever word that has been spoken from the covenant of the wicked one against your life, whatever box that has been rotted out from the pit of hell against the moving this year, something by the power in the name of Jesus is about to move in your life today. Things are about to change hand because the light of the Lord is coming upon your life today. Thank you, Jesus.
Report would you believe? Is it the report of those who have looked down on you, or the report is my rock of glory. I prophesy to you today, your hope has not been cut short. Your hope has not been cut short, because Christ is your glory. Because Christ Jesus is able and abundantly able to deliver and to save. Thank you, Jesus. Oh yes, something is about to happen here. This atmosphere has changed automatically. There is a stirring of the pool here. The man at the pool of Bethesda, he sat there for all the years he was there until he met Jesus. And when he met Jesus, you know what he told Jesus? He said, "What are you doing here?" He said, "I have no man. I have no man." And you see, that man was correct. For everything that is being done in this world, the normative is we need men to do it. We need men to be connected. We need men to go to school. We need men to do one thing or the other. You need somebody to take you somewhere. You need somebody to push you somewhere. And many a times, these are always the situations. For the scripture, anytime God wants to bring about deliverance, he would always send a man. Every time he would always send a man. From the Old Testament, prophets were being sent at intervals to rescue men from some set of situations. But the truth was this, that this time around, God is no longer working with men, because God himself has decided to come in the form of the flesh. And John began to introduce the Savior. He said, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. Through him all things were made, and without him was nothing made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men, and the light shines in darkness, and darkness comprehended not." There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. This one came to be a witness of the light. He was not the light, but he came to be a witness of the light. And anyone who will come through him will receive it. He said, "He so came to him, and so received him not. But as many as received him, he gave them power to become children of God." Bible said, "We behold him, the Word became flesh and dwelt among men." That Word that was God came and dwelt among men. So you see, what Jesus was telling that man is this: you might be correct according to past events that men will always be the system to bring about liberation, but the Creator of men is with you here. You have the Creator of the helpers. You have the Creator of those who are depending on. I command you to arise. Take up your bed and walk, and that man will lose from there. That man will receive the help beyond his expectation. Who am I speaking to here? God is about to break through the cross of prayer. God is about to break through the cross of prayer. You are about to enter into a new season. I see you in a new season. I see you in a new season. 2021, men will say, "Cast it down. We don't have helpers. Cast it down. We don't have support. Cast it down. We are in recession. Cast it down. Coronavirus. Cast it down. But for your sake, you shall be saved." Lift it up. Lift it up. That's your portion. Lift it up. The man that put on the side of never understood that was the day change will come. They said, "How about you?" The man had a beautiful gift. When Peter and John were walking, they saw this man. And you know what? The man were actually asking them to give him money. And the normal thing was that he would stay at the pool of Adam at a beautiful gate. And then the one who comes at the master place would have to give him money. But God is about to beat your expectations. God said, "Life was looking at them, expecting to receive something from them. He was expecting to receive money from them. Peter told him, 'Silver and gold we do not have, but what we have we'll give to you.'" I don't know who I'm speaking to here. God is about to do something beyond your expectation. For God is able and abundantly able to do more than what you can ever think or ask. You might be asking for something small. God is about to give you something big. He said, why he was busy asking for money, Peter said, "Stand up, take